Dear students, the next question is regarding isomers again. See, the question is, how many geometrical and optical isomers are possible for an octahedral complex of the formula type MA2B2C2? There are three sets of two identical ligands each. Okay. See, while we are asked to find the total number of isomers, there is always a risk. That is, sometimes more intelligent students lose mark, less intelligent students gain marks in such questions in this way. Suppose there are six isomers for a particular molecule, and one of a fairly intelligent student could find five, he misses one. Still, if you report five as the answer, he loses one mark. On the other hand, a student who doesn't know anything simply skip the question and gets zero mark, minus one, less than zero. So if it happen, if such things happen three or four times, more intelligent students rank goes very below that of the other girl. Okay, so let's see, our approach must be more scientific here. A2B2C2. So first we apply the case where pair of A, pair of B, pair of C, all the three sets are trans. So look here, A trans to A, B trans to B, C trans to C. Think about any other possibility where we retain A versus A, B versus B, and C versus C in trans positions, but something other than this. No, only this structure is possible. So where all the three pairs are appearing as trans, there is only one structure possible. Now we think about its optical isomerism also. See, when we have to find both the geometrical isomerism and the optical isomerism, this is the way. First you write all the possible geometrical isomers. Then imagine to take mirror image of each and every geometrical isomer. If the mirror image differs from its own object form, the optical isomerism is also there. So whenever you are asked to find the number of optical isomers, etc., first you have to write all the geometrical isomers, then check each for their corresponding optical isomer. Okay, so this is the only way in which A2, B2 and C2 can be arranged in a trans manner. Now we have to check whether this can have an optical isomer. There are two ways to do that. One way is to imagine or draw its mirror image and think about their superimposability. If they are superimposable or identical, then there is no optical isomerism. If they are non-identical, there is optical isomerism. That's one way. The other way is to check the very given structure to have any plane of symmetry, any plane that bisects the molecule into two identical halves. If you check this, you will see there are several planes of symmetry that can divide the molecule into two identical halves. Whenever a molecule possesses a plane of symmetry, its object form and mirror image form will be identical and it will not show optical isomerism. So we check for planes of symmetry. One plane I can say, suppose you see this molecule has C A C A, these four in the plane of the boat, whereas one B is projected outside the boat towards the observer and B projected backwards away from the observer. Suppose you can cut the molecule like this along the plane of the boat, where A, C, A, C atoms are cut through their nuclei, giving two identical halves, then both halves will be identical. So this molecule is having a plane of symmetry, so its object form and mirror image forms are identical, so it has no plane of symmetry. Now coming to the next set, where one pair is trans, other two pairs are cis. For example, here I have maintained A as trans, whereas B and C are cis. See, this molecule has a plane of symmetry also. You can cut through, see this angle between these two B at 45 degree. If you cut like that, it will cut B, B, C, C like this. So you will get two identical halves, means this molecule has a plane of symmetry, so it has no optical isomerism. Here, one more thing you have to take care of. Here I have retained A, A as the trans pair, whereas the other two have maintained as cis pairs. Now you can again take B as the trans pair and A and C as the cis pair. And once again, you can take C as the trans pair and B and A as the cis pair. Okay, so you have three different geometrical isomers possible here. But all are having no optical isomerism, since their object form and mirror image forms are identical. That's all. Now third case, where logically next will be where two pairs are trans, the third is cis. Two pairs trans, third is cis. That is impossible. If you have two pairs as trans, third also have to be trans. You cannot have two pairs as trans and a third pair cis. Such a structure does not exist. So the last case where all the three pairs are cis. Look here, A versus A 90 degree, B versus B 90 degree, C versus C 90 degree. Okay, and this molecule has no plane of symmetry at all. You cannot cut this molecule into two identical halves. Through whichever plane you move your knife, imaginary knife, you won't get two identical pieces, or its mirror image will not be superimposable with the object form. You can check it. In whichever way you can slide it, suppose you invert it to 180 degree and slide it over here. This A and this A, this A, this A will superimpose, but B and C will not superimpose. So this molecule has only one form. Its object form and mirror image forms are non-identical. So this is the only case where there is optical isomerism. So to conclude, it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 geometrical isomers. And one of the geometrical isomer is existing as a pair of enantiomers. That will be your answer. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 geometrical isomers. Among these 5 geometrical isomers, one is existing as non-superimposable, non-identical object and mirror image forms. So there is optical isomerism for that pair alone. Hope you understood that. Take care.